On the Rappaport podcast, you talked about, he asked about a few other NFL players. You said Odell Beckham Jr. isn't great.
No.
You still agree with that?
What makes him great? I beg anybody to show me the greatness in him.
One-handed grab, Odell Beckham.
Put it on the highlight reel, and you describe it, because this is indescribable at times.
This is sick. Put this to music. That may be the greatest catch I've ever seen in my life.
It's in the conversation.
Insane. How do you make that catch?
He catches his ball with three fingers. His thumb, the other two fingers, never touch the ball.
Manning rolling right. And now he fires downfield. He's looking for Beckham, who makes the catch for his third touchdown in his return home to New Orleans.
I'm known for running my mouth. I will not be accountable for what comes out. I don't know. I might have said it. I was kind of gone and light headed. My jacket kind of fresh, bright, red. It is usual. My pants tight, threaded. It seems like everybody dressed tight now. And I just want my credit. Don't get it twisted or dreaded. I am the king and will not be headed to the more no time soon. Risen. Being broke makes my head hurt. So I need the bread or an Excedrin. That I only get my engine revving. When y'all on 10, I'm on 11. I'ma make the news be on this city. Matter of fact, I'm on this very second. I'm in first and y'all in second. And it's first on the edge of the freshest. Call it the club, tell them add to the guest list. What you think? Way more bitches. I can never be too big for my britches. Y'all motherfuckers know who this is. I'm gifted. Merry Christmas.
It's like the elephant in the room, and you know, you don't want to talk about it. And I've gotten to the point in my life where, like, nah, I'm gonna, there's no need to not talk about it. I believe that I will be, hopefully not just the highest paid receiver in the league, but the highest paid, period. The highest paid, period.
Okay. I hear everything you just said about how he has overperformed, outperformed his current deal.
Do you agree?
I have no issue with that.
Okay.
He has certainly done that. But that is not what the young man just said on Uninterrupted, as we just heard. He said the elephant in the room is that one day he's going to be, let's just face it, the highest paid player in the National Football League. This young man, and I do like him. I can't help but like him, but I'm going to be real about him, harshly real about him. He is staggeringly delusional. He has lost all perspective about who he really is and how little, how very little he has actually accomplished in the National Football League so far. So let me get this straight. Last year, a road wild card playoff game at Green Bay, before which he was the tour guide taking a group of his receivers to South Beach to prepare for a game at Lambeau Field. Not to mention that on the opening drive, Eli was Eli playoff hot. And they go boom, boom, boom down the field, and it's 3rd and 5 at the Green Bay 35. It's still nothing to nothing. This is the Giants' first possession. Mm-hmm. And on 3rd and 5, Eli hits Odell with a perfect pass. Just hits him right in the hands for what is going to be a 10-yard gain. And what happened?
He dropped it.
The president of the yacht club, he dropped it. He dropped it, cold dropped it, in the cold in Lambeau, because he was down in South Beach getting ready for the cold at Lambeau Field. And they had to punt. And that was pretty much the end of the New York Football Giants, because they lost that game 38-13.
Fair or not fair, when you do what Beckham and the receiver crew did on the off day Monday, and that pass was a little too deep for Odell Beckham, but he has not been the typical presence or weapon in this game. People will go back and, well, point out that trip.
Odell Beckham Jr., he's been waiting a long time for a new contract, and his patience has paid off. The Giants star receiver has agreed to a contract extension. 1 year left on his rookie deal right now, but he adds a max deal, 5 years, $95 million, including $65 million guaranteed.
How you feel about signing that 5-year extension now?
It's like, oh, well, at least you got paid. That to me is not why I came here. Now, obviously, you want to get paid for your talents and what you've done, but if you have a window this big to maximize your full potential and something's holding you back from doing it, that's more frustrating to me than anything else. I just want to be able to be the very best that I can, and I don't feel like I'm given an opportunity to be the very best that I can, to bring that every single day. And that's really all I want to do, is bring that every single day. I don't want to be held back anymore. And since I've been here, yeah, I've put up numbers and records have been broken and all those good things, which, not to say mean nothing to me, but I know that they could have been double or triple, whatever they are now. That's the part that bothers me. I want to win. I want to be great at what I do. I feel like I could score a touchdown in the first half, touchdown in the second half. Honestly, I feel like I could score every quarter if I'm given a chance, but it's not the case. So I said, oh my God, I need to get 2 touchdowns a game. 100 yards is a minimum. Like, my goals are set very, very high. And if I don't get to help attribute to a team's win or do anything like that, I'm not going to be okay with it, money or no money. Like, I'm just not going to be okay with that.
What is holding you back?
This is what makes me. This is what I am.
Have you seen a guy this thrown off his game before?
Yeah, throw him out of the game, Joe, and then just Mike.
I mean, he's out of control.
Come on.
But I won't stop.
Do it now. Don't hate me, hate the money I see. Clothes that I buy, ice that I wear, flows that I try. Close your eyes, picture me rolling sixes, money falling, bitches, honeys that swollen, the riches. Nas get in ya, most critically acclaimed Pulitzer Prize winner, best storyteller, thug narrator, my style's greater, model data, big threat to a lot of you haters. Commentators ringside try, watching my paper, almost a decade, quite impressive. Most of the best is in the S's, but it's rap shit that I stand for. Expanding more to the big screen, Bill Gates dreams, but it seems you'd rather see me in jail with state dreams. Want me off the scene fast, but good things last, like your favorite MC, still making some mean cast. First rapper to bring a platinum plaque back to the projects. But you still wanna hate? Be my guest, I suggest.
Money is power, motherfucker. I got millions of thugs on salary.
Do it now.
You can hate me now.
I won't stop.
But I won't stop now.
Can't stop.
Cause I can't stop now.
You can hate me.
You can hate me now.
Do it now.
I hate you too.
But I won't stop now.
Come on.
Cause I can't stop now.
Come on.
You can hate me now.
Do it now.
You can hate me.
Do it now, I told you, do it now.
Let's go.
You wanna hate me, then hate me. What can I do but keep getting money? Funny, I was just like you. I had to hustle hard, never give up until I made it. Now y'all saying that's a clever nigga. Nothing to play with, hate on me. I blew, but I'm the same OG. People warn me, when you on top, there's envy. Took my niggas out the hood, but you doubt on us. Saying we left the hood, but can't get it out of us. My bad, should I step on my shoes, give them to you? Here's my cars and my house.
So in this case, Odell, I laughed out loud on this show when they were talking about he's going to become the leader of our team, the leader of your team. And we saw what Josh Norman could do to an Odell Beckham Jr. His buttons are easily pushed. He can go emotionally haywire on you when least expected. You can get in his ear and in his head. And they're never going to win with Odell Beckham Jr. as their centerpiece, as their quote-unquote leader, as their best player. You just gave him $65 million guaranteed. You made him the highest paid wide receiver, and you are 1-5 because he can't do enough to put you over the top. He can't dominate games, control games, be the difference maker every game. He, as good as he is, he can't be that good.
It's a good one.
Let's see, does Odell Beckham charge the football, or does he end up letting it play him? The second row has to get the football. He's got to be over there right now.
We kind of were in a position where we didn't know if they were going to go get it, if they wanted me to go get it. And, you know, I was so far back. When they passed the ball, I was trying to run up there and get in the mix. Just got to it late.
It looked like he didn't die for it. Did he have a chance to die for it?
It sounded like a question that, you know, it just was you just asking just to ask, kind of, you know?
On the onside kick, did you think about...
That sounds like kind of like his question, you know? So I'm not really going to talk about that.
People are going to question your effort for that onside kick. It's already out there. People that say that.
That's fine.
What would your response be?
It was a great kick. You know, sometimes somebody makes a better play than you do. You know, I could dive in there and still not get the ball. So, you know, it was a very tough call. Nobody should ever question my effort or my heart. That's the last thing you could do. You can question me as a person, as a man, whatever you want to do, but my heart and my effort can never be questioned, ever.
Come on. And Odell had the nerve to say, you can question a lot of things, but you can't question my effort. What am I supposed to question on that? I want to know the person that can look at that tape and can honestly say, Odell gave it everything he had to get that ball. I want to find one person. Skip, it's hard to say all or every, but I just want to find one. That says Odell gave everything he could to make sure he get that ball. Odell wasn't trying to get that ball.
He gave no effort.
No.
Which would equate to having little to no heart for the game of football, right?
Skip, and what made it at the end, he faked at the ball.
Yeah, it's funny.
It was not good acting.
Whoa!
Man, deep ball, separation. Beckham can't haul it in. It's fourth down.
And that kick of the ball by Beckham is going to cost him for a delay of game penalty.
Third down and seven now. After that call on Jerry, pass incomplete off the right hand of Beckham. Right? I mean, instead of first down and taking more time off the clock and forcing Doug Peterson to start using these timeouts, and can they run the clock down? And, you know, the first down comes off the board.
You're going to see him right here. He's one-on-one. Maybe a slant.
Incomplete. He looked for Beckham.
As Odell Beckham tries to go to the corner, a little corner stop, comes back, has it, but then drops it.
Beckham back deep. Three receptions today. His first punt return was 15 yards, 9 yards longer than any other return by a Giant on a punt return this season. Ball is loose, bouncing into the end zone, and it's a Panthers touchdown.
Watch here. See him coming over? He's trying to affect the play. It ends up creating all sorts of havoc. And once the ball's touched, Jenkins can't possess it. Kent is now possessed by Apple 24, and then Colin Jones beats everyone to the football in the end zone.
Odell Beckham Jr., but you may not want to watch this. Look at his left leg. Awkwardly hit the turf. Odell Beckham Jr. is down and appears to be writhing in pain. Still on the turf again, left leg.
That you thought Odell was one injury away from being considered perhaps injury prone, just because in his short career he has sustained a couple of injuries. Is that a concern at all if you're the Giants holding on to him?
To me, it's not.
Factor that in. Listen,
he misses the vast majority of 2017, missed the tail end of 2018. If in 2019 he misses time again, you say, okay, you know, that's a trend at this point. But when a guy gets paid and still is near tears at times about the losses, you can say, listen, part of being a professional is understanding the ups and the downs. There are fair knocks about immaturity, about growth, about dealing with the long season, being a leader. But the idea that whether we're 5-11 or 11-5, as long as I'm getting my money, that as long as I'm getting my fame, that is, I know the player. Chris knows the player very well. That's not who he is.
You know, my belief is that character drives talent towards greatness. It's never the other way around. Talent doesn't drive character. Character drives the talent toward the greatness. And you have got to have football character. You have got to understand that I am sacrificing, I am doing this for the other guys, and I have to understand that the other guy, 10 guys, if they don't do their job effectively, I am never going to touch a football. And so until you come to that realization and you're willing to lay it on the line for your teammates and to do what's right for your teammates, I don't care how you are. You'll never have the kind of success that you want to have. And the lack of emotional maturity has been the issue. And I heard you earlier on the show saying, yeah, what has he done since he was great, since the boat trip, since with all these emotional outbursts, I don't remember him being a factor since that time. I don't remember him being a